nature is called the habit forming nature. Mind has one important point. It is called, what is the quality? Habit forming nature. Anything, whatever you put into the mind, it will become a habit. Suppose you take a coffee, for example. If you take the small children, how they will pick up the habit? They don't know coffee, isn't it? And if they are growing up and sometimes the mother and father, they are taking the coffee and they will have smell of it. No, I don't like the milk, I want the coffee. If you give the coffee to them for the first time, second time what he will do, again he will ask for a coffee. If you go to Thailand, for example, I will tell you an example. If you go to Thailand, in some Buddhistic monasteries, even if we go there, sometimes the tigers will come and they will sleep in our lap. Tigers. We will be afraid, but they will not harm you. They will not harm you. All the time the tigers go like this, like the dogs and like the other animals. All the monks, they go with them and they used to live with them. Sometimes tigers also come to us. They will not harm you. Why? Because they never tasted the blood of a human being. They never tasted the blood of any blood of any being. Whenever they give the meat to the tiger, they will totally boil it until the smell of the blood totally goes away. Then this meat they will feed to the tiger. That's why they are not used for. Sometimes they put like this and once they taste the blood of a human, they will become man-eaters. You can't stop them. This is what we call habit-forming nature. The mind will have the habit-forming nature. Once we put something into the mind, as a taste or anything, it will want it again, and again. Whether it is good or bad. Our mind is not good and it is not bad. Whatever you put into the mind, it is a good thing. If it is a good habit, suppose somebody having a habit of doing meditation every day in the morning, straight away we get up from the bed and take his bath and go to the meditation. Somebody is having the habit of having some coffee, for example. Immediately getting from the bed, just they go to the kitchen and make some coffee and eat and take it. Somebody is having some walking habit. Immediately they go for walking, taking their shoes. What we call it is a habit. This is the phenomenon of the mind. You have to understand that. Whatever you feed, whatever you eat, you will become a habit to the mind. That's why you should take that, we have to transform that habit forming nature into the good habit. Habit is a good or bad. So, there is one more interesting thing in the mind is, we are so much worried about the, we are in a worried state with some reason, either financial or family or whatever it is. We need a solution for it. From where we will get the solution? The mind is totally worried with some problem. We need a solution for that problem. Where you will find the solution? From the same mind. You understand? The mind is totally worried. We need a solution. We have to get the solution only from the mind only. Nothing else. This is the point where you are worried and all the worries and solutions also. So here you understand one thing is so important thing in the life. Putting all our mind into the worries or trying for a solution. Two different things. There is a problem. Putting all our effort and putting all our mind into the worry. So I am in so much worry, sir, I have so many problems, sir. If the problem is bothering me like this, sir, and all the time thinking about the worry or a problem is one thing. Trying for a solution is the second. When somebody tries for a solution without putting his total thing into the problem side, definitely 99% they will get the solution. Because his mind is not the serious of the problem or serious of the problem. He is the thing you have to practice in the life. He is the problem with the mind. He is the blessing also from the same mind. So, Annamaya, Pranamaya and Manomaya means with what type of practice you have to make this mind, to try this mind in that way. Is there any method? All our seers, rishis, they found a way with the meditation to train our mind in such a way and to make our mind as a good secretary by ourselves, and we have to train ourselves to become bosses inside, and we have to train our mind in such a way to find the good solutions, not worrying about the problems. This is what we call Annamaya, Pranamaya and Manomaya. Meditation, the purpose of meditation works in that Manomaya question. All the breathing practices are Pranamaya question. All the physical exercises, asanas, related in the Annamaya question. Vijnanamaya question, this is called what we intellect. Discrimination. What is discrimination? We feel so many things are good and so many things are not good. Sometimes what we feel, so many things are not good, may be good. Sometimes what we think is so good may not be good. This is discrimination. This is the above the mind, it's called higher mind, above the mind. What is discrimination means, what is real and what is not real. What is good and what is not good. What is temporary thing and what is the permanent thing. Then we go to the discrimination side, then you will try to think about it, about our own life, is it so important to us or not. When we are concentrating totally on something, is it any permanent value or it will be some temporary value? In the future, how it transforms? All these things, when we discuss about it, is called the discrimination. There it is called in our Sanskrit that the loka again of Gayatri. Gayatri loka is not the mind, it is above, it is the above our ordinary mind. And finally, there we need reading of very good books, following the footsteps of the great people of this earth, reading the scriptures, reading the Bhagavad Gita and other books like that, or any great book, not only in Sanskrit, maybe there are good books maybe in English also. You know, we wrote those books, good books by the great, great people. And try to take good things from those books and try to follow small things, try to follow the small things and slowly going into the real wisdom, the real eternal wisdom. At the same time, giving the importance to the most modern thing, modern facilities, modern research, something like that. And you have to join these two things and make life much more meaningful and purposeful. That is what we call the Vijnanamaya question. And somebody is living like this, he will be in Anandamaya. Anandamaya means, what is the translation for Ananda in English?
Happiness.
Happiness means unhappiness will be there.
Eternal life.
Bliss. If you tell about happiness, how much word will be there? What is that? Unhappiness. If you tell about the light, another thing is, what is that? Darkness. But everything, there is the positive and negative sides, the total bliss. We don't know how it will be. We don't know how it will be. We in a happy state, a joyful state, and a happy situation, comfortable state. We can use all these words. We don't know how it will be, how the bliss will be. It is not unconditional. No conditions there. If you find something, if you want it to be happy, and if you find something to be happy, it will not give you any happy. That's why there is in Bhagavata there is a poem, in Telugu Bhagavata, Bodhana Bhagavata. Dhirulu means, what is Dhiratva? Yes, courage, but this is not the exact meaning of dhira. Dhira means he can stand by himself. He will not be dependent. He will not be depending on any other way. He is called Dhira. Not a brave man. So many, you can find so many brave people. I will, where I have to stop? Brave. It is now 11:45. Okay. 12 o'clock. I will tell you the story of Rama. Then you will understand what is a real word brave. And Rama and Lakshmana, both Rama, Lakshmana and two are in a cave, Sita, three are in the cave, in the forest. 12,000 Rakshas, Karadoshanali names. 12,000, they came to fight with, they came to kill Rama and Lakshmana and Sita. 12,000 are the devils, they came, Rakshasas. Then Lakshmana told Rama, "Brother, you please take care of your wife, my sister. I go there alone and I fight with these 12,000 Rakshasas. This is a small thing. These three are living in a cave. They are very powerful with all the weapons, 12,000. And Lakshmana told Rama, "And you please stay with your wife and I go and fight with them. And if I am in his place, Rama's place, what I will do? Okay, I will take care of my wife, she is living alone, she is staying alone. You please go and fight." Here all the police officers, all the big officers, they sit in the AC room. They send the police people, "Go and fight." You know what Rama said? No, you are younger than me. You see the beauty of reading the scriptures, you will get a lot of things when you read them. Ramayana and Mahabharata, you learn so many things. If you read them properly, said, "You are younger than me. So you please take care of your sister-in-law, Sita. I will go and fight with them." And Rama went alone. He had a fight with them. He killed all the 12,000. See, it's a different story. This is what we call Dhira. Dhira means he stands by himself. "Oh, you please come, you also come with me and you please help me. I am going for a fight." It's not a Dhira. Understand? So, Dhirulu means they stand on their own. Nirapeksha. Nirapeksha means apeksha. What is apeksha? Apeksha, attachment. Our love. Not the unconditional love. Love on our children, love on our own being, love on our friends, is affection. We love people. A lot of affection. Affection is English word. Maybe they got it from affection. From affection, maybe they got affection. We don't know.
There are many words.
Like that. Dhiral nirpekshal. Atma bhiramu laina munulu. Muni means.
Seers.
Yeah, seers all the time they meditate about the God, they wanted to become one with God. Atma Dhramula and Mulu means all the time they were towards that, they all the tapas is towards their Atma. All the time they live with Atma. Mulu. Nishkaranama means without any cause. Nishkarana means a cause. Nishkarana means without any cause, without any reason. Dhiralu, Narapekshalu, Atma Dhiramulaina Gurulu, Nishkaranama, Hari Bhajana Cheyuchunnaru. Always they chant the name of the God. Always they try to live with the Atma and the God. All the time they live on their own without depending on others. For what? Nishkaranama. For no?
For reason.
Can we expect anything in our life without any reason? Can we expect our life a one moment without any reason? Impossible. You understand? Is it not so easy to live in that way? So if somebody wanted to be happy, why I'm telling you the story is, if somebody wanted to be happy, they have to be happy, that's all. without any reason. No, sir, if I get 1 million euros, then I will be happy, sir, for example. If they get 1 million dollars, euros, then, sir, anyhow, I got 1 million. If it is 1.5 million, I will be happy, sir. there is no end to it. If you have a very good house, at the row house, sir. I am seeing my first time row house in Netherlands. In Switzerland, they will find individual house or apartment. Row house. Then our mind goes to not row house, sir. It is a link between other house, it is also comfortable. I want individual house, sir. Then after some time, no, sir, only 2 or 3 rooms are, sir, in other house, sir. You see for the first time a small lettering here. A small one. I did not see any other kind of small one. No, sir, I need a very big washroom and distance, sir, is not enough, sir. Where the entry? There is no entry. Then only I will be happy, sir. Then you will be happy. So somebody, if you find some reason to be happy, it is sure that we will be unhappy. If somebody put a condition, I will be happy, sir, when I get money and become very tall, or this, or that, and if I have a very good job, when I become a boss, or I have a good house, or a good car like that, then only I will become very happy. That means it's a sure way to become. Wanted to be very happy means every moment we should be very happy. We are sitting here, for example. I am giving a lecture because my throat is working well. I should be very happy. If some problem with my throat, with my throat, how can I give a lecture? Already sitting here comfortably, and because you are having, there is no back pain for all of us, you are sitting here comfortably, and there are no rheumatic pains here, and you are sitting here comfortably, and it's not too cold here, we should be happy like that. Because somebody is having a back problem or a knee problem, they can't walk and they can't sit. And every time, whenever somebody wanted to be happy, everything is there always to be happy. Because we are a little bit more rich than other people. There are so many people more than us. There are so many people without any work. There are so many people without any house. There are so many people without any proper clothes. There are so many people without having so many things what we have in our life. That the thing we have to feel to be very happy. Somebody wanted to be happy means they should be happy unconditionally. Enjoy that moment. Hey, I'm so happy, I'm having a cup of coffee. There are so many people who will have a cup of, not cup of coffee, but cup of coffee. They are very happy. That's how we have to be very happy in our life. This attitude takes us to the state of bliss. And somebody, master used to tell all the time, somebody is doing the meditation. And people ask, why all the time you are doing the meditation? He says, I wanted to be so calm and peaceful. Oh, I see. Is it true that you are do all the time doing the meditation and is it possible to become very calm? Yes, sir, I am so very calm, sir. And this man is doing practice. His son is there, a small one, like a small girl. They don't know. They know only one thing, to be happy. They find so many things to be happy, they throw something out. But for them, that is a happy thing. They destroy the mobile and throw it out. They don't know the mobile is so expensive. They like throwing it out there, and it is spoiled. Oh, good. They will be so happy. they will find their own ways to be happy. This poor man is thinking he will be happy only with doing the meditation. Then he came out of the cave. Hey, what are you doing there? Doing nonsense. And then master asked me, sir, just a few minutes back, you are so calm with your meditation. And why are you shouting at your daughter and the son who are very smart? They find their own ways to be very happy. And but you are not so happy because you are so angry. What happened to your meditation for 2 years or 3 years? It's a stupid meditation. You understand? Unless you are that, there is no use of any meditation or reading a good book or going to a very good lecture. And that's why in the beginning I told, it is an attitude, not an achievement. How many years you meditated and how many years you did asanas and how many years we did pranayama. If you are there, all these things are useful. If you are not there, all these things will become useless. So yoga is an attitude, not any achievement. Or I am practicing my meditation for so many years, sir. What do you do with that? You have to do something in your life, or you have to do something in others' life, in a very peaceful and happy way. This is what we call the science of yoga. The syllabus is there. We have to learn them slowly and slowly and slowly. But understand one thing, it will not take much time. 1 hour a day, if we cannot spend 1 hour a day, we feel we are very busy. We are not so busy really, but we feel we are very busy. That is the real problem. Frankly speaking, we are not so busy because we spend a lot of time on our phone. We spend a lot of time on television. We spend a lot of time in the kitchen. We spend a lot of time on the Skype. We find a lot of time for many, many things. But when we come to the practice part of it to make our life much more meaningful and healthy and happy, and we try to believe ourselves that we are very busy. That is the only problem here. Really, we are not so busy. So even you say, I am very busy, I will ask you at what time you will get up from your bed. So, sir, on Sunday, 10 o'clock, sir. Ordinary days, I have to go to the office, 6 o'clock, sir. And I will ready-made answer with me. So, anyhow, you are getting 6 o'clock. Get by 5 o'clock, one hour before. Then practice it. No, sir, I can't get by 6 o'clock, sir. And at least 5:30. Sir, you are telling me to practice for 1 hour, but now you are giving me discount. 30. I'm not giving you discount here. I'm telling you, get up by 5:30 and take off half an hour in the morning when you are going to bed. Sir, by the time the channel closes, the TV channel closes, or by the time the serial something closes, but tell me what time? 11 o'clock, at least 10 o'clock. So just extend the time, 10:30, and make the other 10 minutes, 15, 30 minutes the night. What is the problem here? Night time, you practice the meditation and this thing, and day time, practice pranayama and asanas. 30 minutes, asanas and pranayama. Just 3G, 30 minutes. And practice the meditation 30 minutes in the night. What is the problem here? Your life will become much more cheerful, much more joyful. And so many things come to our mind, and so many things will reorganize in our life, rearrange in our life. Heart patterns will be changed, I'm telling you. So many miracles will happen. Miracles means not like in the movies. I'm not telling that. So much of thought process will be changed right here. Life will become much more joyful and much more cheerful and much more meaningful and much more purposeful. This is the real purpose of doing the yoga. And then after the break, so let us start using 10 or 15 minutes after the time. Then let us practice, not asanas. Let us practice a little bit pranayama and